Greetings and welcome to the Introduction to Astronomy. In this week's discussion on the celestial sphere, we are going to talk about the zodiac and what that means in astronomy. So let's get started here. And we want to first of all talk about what is the zodiac. So what do we mean when we say that? You often hear it associated with astrology, but its origins are actually in astronomy. And the zodiac is the set of constellations that are located along the ecliptic. Now, you may recall the ecliptic is the path the sun appears to take in the sky. Now, formally, it measures 8 degrees north and south of the ecliptic. So the constellations that are within that range are considered the constellations of the zodiac. And there are 12 primary ones that occur here. Now, because they're located near the ecliptic, that means they will have small ecliptic latitudes. So they are all of the objects that are close to the ecliptic. And the ecliptic is not only the path of the sun, but also the path taken by the moon and the planets. So these are important and were important to ancient astronomers because they were the constellations through which the sun, moon, and planets would pass. And that's why they're important. It's not because they're the brightest or most prominent constellations that exist. In fact, they are not. But they have been important in the past. Now, we can see them here. Here's an older chart showing the various different constellations and roughly the months through which they would occur. And the sun, moon, and planets would then pass through these over the course of the year. Now, they would pass through them because they are orbiting around as well. So all of the objects, Earth and the moon and planets, are all moving. So they will appear to move through these different constellations over the course of a year. Now, the very early origins date back to Babylonian astronomy. So very early astronomy gave us many of these early constellations. But more recently, it's based on the International Astronomical Unit boundaries given for the constellations. Adds in an additional constellation in the region of the zodiac, which is Ophiuchus. Now we can see that on the chart coming up here. And as we look at this, when we look at the chart here, the constellations in the gray with that dotted line going through them are the constellations of the zodiac. So you'll recognize many of those names, I assume. But you can also note that there is one section here where it goes through a different constellation. And that is right in this region here, where the constellation of Scorpius is too far south. And the sun does not pass higher than that. So it passes through Ophiuchus instead. And in fact, it only has a very short time in a small portion of the constellation of Scorpius. So as you look at these, you can see that the sun will spend a long time in certain constellations and less in others. Now, when these are used for astrological purposes, everything is evened out and it's averaged to divide the zodiac among the ecliptic into 12 different regions of all of the same length. But here you can clearly see that the sun will spend a lot of time in Virgo, a lot of time in Taurus, but much less in places like Cancer or Aries. So that's what the zodiac constellations are. Let's finish up here with our summary and we'll take a look at that. So what we've looked at is that the zodiac is the region of the sky located along the ecliptic. The constellations here are important because of the regions that they occupy and the objects that pass through them, and they may or may not contain the brighter stars. So that concludes this discussion on the ecliptic. We'll be back again next week for another topic in astronomy. So until then, have a great day, everyone, and I will see you in class.